Hello. So I was just plugging in the patch cable, and the cable is just barely long enough to get over here from where the amp is. It's a decently long cable, but anyways, I was plugging it in and it made that noise, and it made it a lot, and I hope I don't anger my dad. And you can see by the paint, it's actually marker on the guitar, that all that hard work that my friend did, the original owner of the guitar, it's slowly being eaten away by me using the guitar. And I feel bad about that, but I'm sure it's okay. I can't help but think what this learning process would be like if I did it when I was a teenager, when I was supposed to do it, or when most people do it.
You're supposed to do it.
Yeah, it's when most people do it, but I don't. Maybe not even most people, but I just get the impression that's when a lot of people start, and I'm just wondering what that would be like. And I'm betting, everything else being equal, you'd probably get a lot more discouragement. So basically, I film a guitar video. The stuff it takes on the computer to actually get onto the internet actually takes a number of hours. And I have to be here. I have to at least check in with the computer, but by luck, I happen to be on the computer all the time, so it doesn't matter. So anyways, the point is, my fingers have a chance to heal. During this intermission, and so I think when I first, the beginning of the video probably has me performing at my best. Also, of course, energy, like physical and mental energy. I feel like there's auxiliary things I should be doing, like reading books on theory and stuff like that, which I've been recommended. But I think I've been practicing in earnest less than a month. And this is like theoretically a lifelong thing. So I shouldn't rush myself or feel that I'm not living up to this standard of self-teaching, if that makes sense. So that was A. I don't know if you watched the last video, but I was having trouble with that one. G. So for this, basically one of the ways I got to it is just by completely going overboard to make sure all my fingers are up. And the more I spend time in that position, the more out of position I get. So let's just shake it off and then try to do that again. So yeah, I'm kind of getting G. And so I've done that 8? I don't count for some reason. Because I don't count.
No, you count.
It is a joke. So the 7s. That's A7. E7. There's very little difference between E7 and E. I'm not sure why that is. I mean, there's only one string that is different, but yeah. Well, let's listen to E7 and E. So this is E7. No, this, wait. This is E. So when you do it one at a time, it sounds different. Oh. So I was doing something wrong. Yes, that's the case. So yeah. With G7, I put my pinky on the 6th string and my index on the 1st string. And my ring finger on the 2nd string. And that's a little bit tricky, but it's good kind of, because it naturally forces you to not mute the neighboring strings. So I did E7, A7, G7, did I do D7?
I don't
know. Yeah, so that's that for some reason. It doesn't seem too important to me that I know that. I don't know why. Just my state of mind right now. I'm getting close to the time where I would go for a clonazepam, and I have to decide if I want to suffer today or just relax and take more than I did yesterday. And of course, long term, I want to take less, so I have to think about that. And I also have to think about how I haven't been getting a full night's sleep. So I think in conclusion, I will take more today. So there, now you know. Something you didn't want. Something you had no care about. I completely forget how I got my fingers here. Well, the first string is muted. So I'm muting the first string in that, and I think last time I filmed this, I was able to do that more or less without difficulty, and I almost, I'm smoking inside, which is why I keep coughing periodically. So I almost, I think I got that somewhat the last video, and I'm getting tired. It's only been 12 minutes, but I'm getting mentally tired. So yeah, something I should mention, which I'm not sure if you realize based on me looking, I think you can see my head most of the time, but basically I was looking at the fretboard and not looking at whatever you call the area where you strum, which implies I have a somewhat basic knowledge of how far apart the keys are, the strings are. So yes, I'm tired, and I'm going to do relaxing things, none of which are controversial, as far as I know. But when I say I'm tired and I'm going to do relaxing things, you kind of think to yourself, he's going to do something like that, why isn't he telling us? But basically just, I'm rambling. Obviously I'm tired. Thank you.